Hey guys, how are you doing? I'm Anime Intensity. Welcome back to my channel. Today we're having another Manga Monday where I talk about cool new manga series or releases and say how I feel about them, whether or not I recommend them and stuff like that. So, hello! Today's manga is actually a really big volume of manga. It's like an omnibus volume, and it is of Kemono Friends by Fly, created by the Kemono Friends Project, and this was actually made by Yen Press. So just take a look at this cover! Isn't this absolutely just like the cutest thing that you've ever seen? This is absolutely adorable. I love the cover. It's also very smooth. Just saying. I take all these little things into consideration when I get manga. So I love the way it feels, love the way the cover looks, and this is the back right here. So very, very beautiful color illustrations by Fly. And yeah, pretty, look at this. It's a pretty good sized volume of manga. It has, I believe, 20 chapters of Kemono Friends, which is awesome. I believe this is like the complete like series for Kemono Friends, at least the manga version of it. It also has an anime adaptation of the same name. It's 12 episodes long and was released a few months ago. It's still fairly recent, and while that anime was very different, especially in terms of its CGI usage, it still had a lot of charm, just like this manga does. So, Kemono Friends is about this girl named Nana, and she gets a job being a caretaker at Japari Park, where girls are, you know, animals. There are animal girls in this park, and it's such a delightful read, such a light-hearted read. And I have to admit that this volume of manga right here is more of a slice of life manga, where it's like cute girls doing cute things. You're seeing all the cute little animal girls do various things, and it's just a really cute manga. You see how these animal girls go play in the snow, you see how they go to a maid cafe, you see how they, you know, have Halloween, you see how, like, a bunch of little things like that. They go to the aquarium, they go see a concert, they learn how to sing, all these little things. Simple things like that are seen in Kemono Friends. There really isn't like a plot that really lasts throughout the entire manga. It's more like every chapter is something different. You see all the different animal girls, and you know, while some make more appearances than others, it's just really great to see the traits of these characters, you know? Like, like everybody has their own traits that we definitely see in the anime as well. Like, the silver-crested ibis, or ibis, whatever you call it. She likes to sing, but she's tone-deaf, so she sounds horrible, which is why she's one of my favorites, because she's hilarious. We see her, we see Cheetah, we see Serval, we see so many different animals, koala, you know, elephants, you know, there's so many animal girls, and they are all cute. This is something that you definitely will observe if you read the manga, is that the art style is absolutely adorable. Like, just look at the cover and you're gonna know that the contents of this manga is just absolutely adorable. Like, look at that. I love the artwork. I think it's really cute, especially the animal girls themselves. All of them are just so, so nicely designed, which is a big contrast to how the anime looks, because if you've seen the anime, you know that the art was definitely not exactly its strong point, but, like, just, I love it. So, I gotta admit, the artwork is something that is very, very enjoyable in this volume of manga. The tone of the manga is just very lighthearted, and it's about friendships and accepting who you are. You know, even if you don't want to be that particular animal, you wish you could be something else. It's about really appreciating what you are, who you are, and, you know, the friendships that you make along the way. And it's really, really sweet how they just do ordinary things like, you know, actual humans would, because, you know, they are animal girls. But they also have their traits from, like, being an animal. Like, oh, like, we can make this because we're, you know, we're a koala. We can make this, you know? Or, you know, hey, it's time to hibernate, so take care of me. You gotta get my stuff, you know, get my groceries because I need to sleep, you know? There are little things like that which connect the girls to their animal counterparts, I guess you could say. And it is just really charming. The characters, their personalities, they're just, their harmony, I guess you could say, is something that really shines in this volume of manga. However, if I did have to compare it to the anime, I would have to say the anime does have more of a consistent plot. It also has more world building. So in that aspect, I do think that the anime for Kemono Friends is a bit stronger. The manga is still enjoyable though. Basically, the manga is a cute girls doing cute things manga, except with animal girls instead of regular, just normal human girls. So that's the gimmick, I guess you could say, in Kemono Friends, is that, you know, it's kind of doing the same thing that other cute girls doing cute things manga, you know, do, except that they are animals. So it doesn't really have much else aside from that, and that's a weakness for it, is that it's still basically just something else that I could read. But the only thing different is the fact that these girls are animal girls. Otherwise, it's nothing too different. While I wouldn't say that Kemono Friends Welcome to Japari Park is something that's necessary to read, I still really enjoyed it. It definitely put a smile on my face because it was so delightful, and that's what counts. However, it's definitely not something that I would read a second time. It's something that I've read once and I can part with it. So while it's still enjoyable, it's something that I wouldn't reread.
If you like slice of life or, you know, cute girls doing cute things, you will definitely have cute animal girls doing cute things. So that's very, very cool. And I just like the overall, like, feel to the manga. It's a quick, easy read, and even though it doesn't have necessarily a plot that, you know, covers the entire volume, it's still really cute to read. The overall feel is just something that I really enjoyed for this volume of manga. If you'd like to read Kemono Friends, it's available at all major book retailers and or Amazon if you want to buy it online. But yeah, if you've read the manga for Kemono Friends, I know it's still pretty recent, but if you've read it, please let me know how you felt about it. It's definitely a quick, easy read, even though it is kind of lengthy. I think like around 300 something pages, so there is a length to it, but it's something that anyone could enjoy. Very simple, and you know, I wish I had a Japari Park. This sounds like fun. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching this video. Totally, totally appreciate it. Please like, share, or subscribe if you like this video, and I will see you guys next time.